Let's take a look at the gospel in the streets, coming up next on Catholics Matter. Good to see you again on Catholics Matter. You know, if you're like me, when you drive around town, very often at street corners and especially at freeways, on-ramps, off-ramps, you'll see homeless people very often with signs up asking for help. I think it's a phenomenon that touches all our hearts wherever we go. And, you know, here in the city of Phoenix, Arizona, there's a little oasis, so to speak, of Catholic love and outreach. It's known as Andre House, and with us today is the director, the six-year director of Andre House, Father Eric Schimmel. Eric, good to have you here.
Good to be here. Thank you.
Now, tell us just, Andre House is named for what? Blessed Andre, I'm guessing.
You know. He's actually now Saint Brother Andre Bisset.
Saint Brother Andre Bisset.
A couple of years ago, he was canonized, and I had the great privilege of being a Eucharistic minister for that canonization ceremony.
Well, and the Andre House, of course, is it's sort of like, okay, I'm going to go ahead and just say it. It's Notre Dame's little outreach right there in the center of Phoenix, but it is. It's the Congregation of the Holy Cross.
Yes.
You know, always associated, of course, with the mothership.
South Bend, Indiana.
South Bend, Indiana at Notre Dame. Mm. But the inception of Andre House, I mean, how did it come about, and how did you embrace this tremendous mission of really kind of bringing the gospel to the streets?
In 1984, there is a Holy Cross priest who actually had been working at the University of Notre Dame who had something in his heart to go do something for people who are poor. And you know, he was talking with one of the seminarians who became a transitional deacon that year. And they decided that they would open up a house along the lines of the Catholic worker model of Dorothy Day in downtown Phoenix area to reach out to people who are poor and people who are experiencing homelessness. And in October or so of 1984, they opened up a house on Polk Street, around 10th Avenue and Polk near Van Buren, and so in the downtown area. And you know, they've both been working in different parishes and helping and talking about the ministry that they were starting. And so, believe it or not, in November, there happens to be a holiday that people want to celebrate with food. And so although they were just looking at housing and being a simple house for our homeless men, lots of people started donating turkeys. Like, what are we going to do with all these turkeys?
And so the
happy solution in the
freezers.
Catholic work was not freezers, but cook them.
Cook them.
Make a soup, bring it down to the tent city that was about 10 blocks away from our house and serve a meal on the street.
That's the jail in Phoenix, yeah, pretty much, yeah.
Okay. And that's why our soup line started, because of the generosity of the people in the community, you know, at a time of great need and at a time of thanksgiving, thanking God for the gifts that they have and therefore sharing their gifts with others. And then, you know, how am I going to do it? Well, this place probably would know, and it's like, okay, well, we're not exactly sure how we will do this, but we will. And that one soup line has now developed to, we serve dinner six nights a week, averaging over 600 meals a night.
That's amazing. You still have a special affinity for turkeys.
We do. We do have a special affinity for turkeys. Every Monday evening is a turkey pasta dish. Most people donate the turkeys between November and December when the price tends to drop, and then our freezer gets stacked with turkeys, but it is okay to give us the bird at those times or even other times of the year, and we'll freeze them, and we go through about six or seven turkeys every week.
You know, Eric, I would imagine that's not an easy ministry to carry out. I think just from an emotional level to see, you know, the plight of people, but I think especially you as the director, an additional stressor, so to speak, you're responsible for acquiring resources, you know, to make the ministry operate. Now, that's got to be something of a, you know, how do you make all that happen?
A lot of faith, a lot of trust, and a lot of, wow, did I do that right? We are blessed with an incredible community of volunteers and benefactors. And, you know, part of me always thinks, well, we could use more, we could do more. For example, when I started at Andre House a little more than 5 years ago, we were averaging about 2,000 blankets a year that we would give out to people over the course of the year. You know, then the economy tanked and the recession hit in. We now average about 4,000 blankets a year because, you know, some of the shelters in the area don't give out blankets until a certain time of year. And a lot of them don't give out blankets in the summertime either. It's like, well, why would somebody need a blanket in the summer? It's like, what are you sleeping on?
Right.
Not right. And so we do give out blankets all year long so that people can stay safe and healthy. And you know, a lot of what I depend on is a core staff. You know, Brother Richard has been at Andre House almost since its inception, and relying on him for a lot of institutional
That's
history
coming up on
and
30
wisdom
years.
And guidance.
Yeah.
It is coming up on 30 years. And you know, a lay core staff. We usually have about 5 people doing an AmeriCorps year, full time service with us. Then we have regular volunteers who come different days of the week to help sort donations or to help cook the meal on a Monday or a Tuesday or a Wednesday, et cetera. And getting input from our volunteers as well as the staff, I know I can't do this alone. Even by myself with the help of God, I'm weak. I can't do this alone. We at Andre House depend on the community as we depend on God.
Right. Now, what's a typical day look like? I mean, you know, your community members, I would imagine, I know you offer Mass for them.
Right.
You know.
Right. Monday through Thursday, a typical day is 2 people from our staff will head off from our parking lot to St. Mary's Food Bank, where we pick up a couple 100 pounds of food for that evening's meal. They come back and unload. At 9 o'clock, we have a miniature staff meeting, which everybody checks in. What did you do the day before? Were there any issues that everybody needs to know about, either positive or negatively? What are you scheduled to do that day? Are there any curveballs, like, you know, today? I didn't let everybody know. I'm not going to be doing my usual shift. I'm going to be talking with you.
Okay.
And then, and then
managed to disrupt your day today.
It is in a blessed way. And then at 9:30, we open up the parking lot and we have Mass outside in the parking lot. Our guests who come in who are looking for clothing for laundry services.
Not in the summer.
Yes, we do it in the summer. Yes.
Okay.
And, you know, as you may know, albs don't necessarily breathe all that well in the summertime.
Mm.
But they're with the grace of God, you know. You know, as our guests have to stay outside most
What's
of the summer.
What's a little sweat?
What's a little sweat if you're celebrating sacred mysteries?
Exactly.
After Mass, we open the building and we have an office where people can make phone calls or get hygiene products, simple pain medicines. You know, most of these are all donated to us, especially small travel size hygiene products are great for our guests who come in. And they're guests, they're not clients. We want to be a place of hospitality. We break at noon. We close everything down and we have a prayer together as staff and volunteers. We break bread together with lunch as staff and volunteers. Then we open up in the afternoon between 1 and 3 o'clock, the place where people can make phone calls and get hygiene and toiletries and blankets. That's open again. We also offer showers in the afternoon. Between 1 and 3 o'clock, you can get 30 people showered. You know, if you want to talk about feeling like a human being, especially
Absolutely.
Summertime.
Oh, my goodness, you know, that would be
Sometimes
be
we
huge.
Joke that we want to add to the corporal works of mercy that you should shower the stinky.
That'd be a good addition. Now, of course, I noticed you bought a little bag of tricks here.
Yeah.
What have you got in this box?
Blankets. We need blankets year-round, but as you're thinking about blankets, think about what would I want to keep me warm at night in the wintertime, in the summer, but especially in the wintertime. And if we end up with lots of thick blankets in the summertime, that's a lot more padding and cushioning so that people don't scald themselves as they sleep at night outside.
Then I have blankets.
Basic needs. Jeans, especially men's jeans, size 32 to 36, we can't keep them in stock.
My goodness.
And a lot of our guests want to do labor work because that's easier to get in the door at first and then try to get other and so they want something more sturdy. So jeans are wonderful. And then, you know, basic necessities, underwear. You know, if you are going to take a shower and then at the end of the shower, what are you going to put on? Most of us put on clean clothes. Our guests don't always have that opportunity.
Right.
You know, that's why they come to our clothing closet, but also, you know, we tend to run out of the undergarments faster. Underwear and, of course, its friend, the socks.
Socks.
We don't make socks.
Right, I could have guessed that was coming next.
Right. But just also...
Razors, shampoo.
Razors, shampoo, deodorant.
Okay.
We can't keep deodorant in stock, or lip balm.
Oh.
This is an area where, you know, not only do people want to brush their teeth
and toothpaste,
you know, sometimes, you know, the chapped lips.
Feeling like a human being, exactly.
Whatever I basically need to feel like a human being when I'm bathing or doing my natural grooming, our guests want the same type of things. They're people too, and that's the underlying reason. Why do we do this? They're our brothers and sisters. Whatever you do to the least of my brothers, you do to me. And we are called to reach out to see Christ in each person.
This is a service to Christ. Now, if somebody, you know, obviously, I mean, Phoenix residents can bring things to Andre House.
Yes.
No, but if somebody wanted to support Andre House, I know you have a website.
We do have a website, which is andrehouse.org.
Andrehouse.org. And it's set up to receive donations and the like.
Right.
Eric, this is phenomenal, putting the works of mercy into, putting flesh on the works of mercy. But thanks so much for joining us today. Bless you and your good works there and all those wonderful people there. Always enjoy seeing you over at Newman Center at ASU. And everyone, we'll see you next time on Catholics Matter. Take care.